Yeah, good morning, everyone. We saw US market showing positive signs, continuing in that US market. That is mainly yesterday driven by the package which has been announced by the US government on Friday evening. That is $1 trillion infrastructure bill which got passed in both the houses and now with the president. So that has supported the market along with good results which were coming in the US market. Today morning, Asian markets are more of a flattish and US market are marginally down. And even the commodities are more of a flattish. Oil is at 83.5 and it's flat. Aluminium up by around 0.3, copper up by around 0.7. Iron ore is also flat and steel is looking more of a flat. So overall indication from the international market are of more of a flattish type of market for today. Now I'll request technical team to take up from here. Yeah, Swati or Vikas, anyone?
Yeah, good morning all of you. See, yesterday we see some positive momentum in market and Nifty sustained important resistance above level, that is Nifty is trading above 18,000 level. We see yesterday and day after Murat trading also that Nifty managed to sustain important resistance zone and close above that important resistance zone. So we expect positive momentum in market. But today we expect intraday is opening is flattish note, but remained a sideways zone. Important support zone for Nifty is 18,000. And next important resistance level is 18,140-150 level. If Nifty break that level, then we see some further momentum towards 18,300-340 level in upside. Bank Nifty also looks positive at current level. Next important resistance for Bank Nifty is 40,000. If Bank Nifty sustain that level and break that level intraday, then we expect further momentum towards 40,300, 40,600 for next week, coming week. Support place around 39,500, 39,340 at downside. To expect a positive momentum also in Bank Nifty, but Bank Nifty have trading below the important resistance level. If that break, then we expect further momentum. Nifty Finance also trading near the resistance zone and that is come around 19,200. And if break that level, then we expect further momentum towards 19,300-19,440 upside. Support place around 19,100 at downside. So we expect three index trading in positive momentum and we see some positive momentum in coming a few trading session also. In stock specific, JK Cement looks positive, Muthoot Finance looks positive at current level. So we expect further positive momentum in these two stock also. IB Real Estate also looks positive at current level. We already given a call in IB Real Estate. Upside target around 204 and support place around 275-78 at downside. Second, Ace also given a call around 256 and above to expect further momentum in 270-280 in upside. Stop loss place around 245 at downside. So we can keep watch this stock also. And PVR also looks positive at current level also. We also given a call in PVR. Target is 18.20 in upside. Stop loss place around 17.40 at downside. That's it for technical.
Thank you, Vikas. Yeah, hi, this is Nirav here. There's some problem with my Zoom. So I'll be taking it from Jihan's ID. Total open interest continues to be low from the derivative perspective. Also, the PCR is at comfortable levels. It has seen a jump from 0.8 odd levels to 1.1, which is good. It has come up above the one level, which is very important. Yeah. Importantly, the VIX has fallen from 18 odd levels 216 odd. Yes, it has come up yesterday, but still at comfortable levels. I believe this is a good sign. As I said yesterday as well, I believe the data is positive, majorly positive, and we should witness further buying in Nifty. We can see Nifty going up towards the 18,400, 18,500 odd levels. The PCR at 18,000 strike has gone up above one, which is also very good. So overall, I believe you know, there are positive signs for the index and stocks as a whole. So one should be long. If Nifty does fall towards the 18,000 levels, one should be buying with a stop loss of 17,900, which is a strong support area on the downside. From the stock specific front, Bharti yesterday witnessed very good buying. Even BPCL, HPCL, as I've been mentioning in the last few trading sessions, they should continue to witness good buying, and definitely you'll see some more buying coming in the next few trading sessions. So look out to buy these stocks if you know, the stocks come down for a bit. That's it from my side. I'd like to ask the fundamental team to take over, please.
Good morning. Yesterday, life insurance data for the month of October has come out, and the annualized premium equivalent, APE, for all private players combined grew by 20%. This figure year to date was for 29%. It is slightly come down. Outperformers remain the same names that have done well since the start of the current financial year. So Bajaj Allianz grew by 36%, SBI Life 27%, and ICICI Prudential 25%. HDFC Life grew in line with industry. It grew by 19%. Max Life underperformed and grew by just 1%. So expect continued outperformance from SBI Life and ICICI Pru. On results front, Karur Vysya Bank results were marginally above expectation. Credit cost declined to 1.2% during the quarter from an average of 1.8 to 2% in last six quarters. Gross NPAs declined from 8% to 7.4% on one hand, but on other hand, restructured book increased from 2% to 3%. So in the short run, we are neutral over here. Sundaram Finance result was okay. Profit was in line with estimate. However, credit cost was on higher side, and also restructured book almost doubled to 9.3%. If we look at all auto financing companies, then out here the restructured book is the highest, and it is the lowest for Shriram Transport Finance. So expect in the near term Sundaram Finance to remain range bound. Although CV on the whole as an industry will do well, so all the CV financiers over the medium term should do well. Ujjivan Small Finance Bank result was below expectation. NPA increased while restructured book doubled to 10%. We think even the rest of two quarters of the current financial year will be bad and will have high credit cost because still they have around 3% odd net NPA, and if we add the 10% restructured book, then almost 13% book is unprovided, so stocks should remain under pressure. That's it from my side. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. RSWM has posted its result. The company has posted okay set of numbers for the quarter. Share is trading at 6.1 times TTM EPS. Thank you.
Yeah, good morning. Shyam Metallics and Energy reported its result. The result was okay. Revenue was flattish quarter on quarter. EBITDA was down 9% sequentially at rupees 624 crores. The company has also announced interim dividend of rupees 2.25 per share, and the record date for the same is 19th November. Thank you.
Yeah, apart from that, a few more results. Like Britannia has announced the results, and the results were below expectations, mainly on account of some pressure on the margins. Margin came a bit lower than what was expected In fact, it has come at around 15.5, whereas the expectation was around 17.2. Though results are below, but what we are seeing that the prices has already corrected from highs of over 4,600 or 500 levels to around 3,700 levels. And at current price, the shares is trading at attractive valuation of 43 times FY23 earning. So at such a downside from here looks limited for the stock and may see some bounce back once the things is company is able to pass on the cost. So it may take some time, but overall direction wise looks reasonably okay. Then 3i Infotech came up with the numbers and the numbers were declining. In fact, company has reported loss at EBITDA level in this quarter and reported loss of around 18 crore. Whereas last quarter, the loss was, it was more of a 0.6 crore of EBITDA profit. Seems to be there is some extraordinary expenses in other expenses item as it has increased substantially quarter on quarter. So need to get clarification on that. But otherwise, the direction wise, the result is declining. Then Aurobindo Pharma came up with the numbers and here again, the numbers are declining. In fact, the revenue has come in more of a marginally lower than what was expected. It was expected at around 6,100 against that 5,900 revenue has come. And even the margin EBITDA has also come lower than what was expected. EBITDA margin has come at 20%, whereas the expectation was of around 21.2%. Here again, the share prices are at near to 52-week low and shares is already discounting a lot of negativeness in this result. So, and the share is trading somewhere around 10 times FY23 earnings. Then two sugar company announced their results. This quarter is generally a soft quarter for sugar company. As such, Balrampur Chini reported numbers which were more of a flattish type of number as compared to last year. And similarly, EID Perry has reported the number. Here again, though there was some marginal decline in year-on-year numbers, but being considered a soft quarter, the decline may not be of great aptitude. So both the companies has reported more of a flattish type of numbers. Then Precol has come up with the numbers and the numbers were okay. And Soba developer has announced the results. The results are showing some improving signs. The pre-booking figure the company has already announced at the end of the quarter and the figures were known to the market and as such the key parameter was already known well before that. So these results may not have great relevance from that perspective. And but apart from that, the construction activity and all has been done well and came ahead of market expectations. So overall, property markets are doing comparatively well and the outlook is positive. LG Equipment came up with very good numbers in this quarter. The numbers had shown a good improvement in this quarter. In fact, revenue and EBITDA all came ahead of expectations. Revenue came at 650 crore, whereas the expectation was around 550 crores. And the EBITDA came at around 80 crores and expectation was at around 53 crores. So very good improvement from expectation. And even year on year also, it shows improvement of around 35% in revenue and around 20% in EBITDA. So overall results looks quite attractive and can see some positive movement in today's trade. No doubt valuations are also priced attractively at around 35 times. FY23 earnings. So that's all from us. Thank you very much and have a good day.
Subscribe to our YouTube channel for in-depth interviews of India Inc. and press the bell icon so that you do not miss our updates.